Section 1.2, Exponents. Large and small numbers are frequently represented with powers of 10. For example, the number 9.8 billion is often written 9.8 times 10 to the 9. This is an example of a power of 10. In order to be able to do mathematics with large and small numbers, you will find it very helpful if you know a few facts about exponents. Hence, we review some basic properties of exponents in this section. Consider the expression 3 squared. The number 2 is referred to as an exponent, or a power, while the number 3 is referred to as the base. In this section, we're going to review some basic features that are true about exponents. In the table below are listed two properties of exponents. These are the two most intuitive properties that exist. Let's look at the first property. If you take a number a and you raise it to the power p, and then you take the same number a and raise it to the power q, the result is simply taking the number a and raising it to the p plus q. Why should that be true? Well, let's take an example. Suppose you took 10 squared and you multiplied it by 10 cubed. Well, let's look at what that really is. 10 squared is 10 times 10, while 10 cubed is 10 times 10 times 10. Really, what we have are 5 factors of 10 when we list out all of these factors. 5 factors of 10 give 10 to the fifth. Look at the exponent 5. 5 is equal to 2 plus 3. 2 factors of 10 times an additional 3 factors of 10 give us a total of 5 factors of 10. That property should be more or less intuitive. The next property concerns division, whereas the top property concerned multiplication. If you take a number a, raise it to the p, and then take the same number a, raise it to the power q, and then divide, the result is the number a raised to the p minus q. Why should that be? Let's look at a motivating example. Suppose we take 10 to the fifth and we divide by 10 cubed. Let's write this in factored form. 10 to the fifth is 5 factors of 10. 10 cubed, that's 3 factors of 10. You can see we have 3 factors of 10 that can be canceled in the numerator and the denominator, leaving 2 remaining factors of 10 in the numerator. Notice that 5 take away 3 leaves 2. We had 5 factors of 10 in the numerator, 3 factors of 10 in the denominator. That made it possible to cancel out 3 factors of 10 from the numerator and the denominator, and that left us with just 2 factors of 10 in the numerator. Knowing these properties will allow you to perform calculations involving exponents more easily. Example 1.3. Simplify the following expressions using the properties above. Leave your answers with powers of 10. Go ahead and pause the recording now and work the parts of this example on your own. Then continue playing the recording to see the example worked. Okay, let's go ahead and work part A. In this example, we're dividing a power of 10 by another power of 10. According to the property above, we should have 10 to the 12 minus 7. We would subtract the exponents. This will give us 10 to the fifth when we are done. Let's look at part B. In part B, we're multiplying. When we multiply powers of 10, we add the exponents. So in this case, it would be 8 plus 6, which gives us 10 to the 14. Let's look at part C. In this problem, you may find it helpful to split this one fraction into two fractions so that we can isolate the powers of 10 by themselves. In this case, we could rewrite this as 35 over 7 times 10 to the 8 over 10 to the 5th. Now we simplify each fraction separately. 35 over 7 is 5. 10 to the 8 divided by 10 to the 5 will require us to subtract the exponents. 8 take away 5 is 3, and so we're left with 10 cubed. This is the simplified form. Now, let's look at two additional properties of exponents that are not necessarily intuitive, but they are the logical consequences of the two properties we have just seen. The first property listed in the table says that any positive number raised to the power 0 is equal to 1. So, for example, if I wrote 2 to the 0, that equals 1. If I wrote 3 to the 0, 4 to the 0, if I wrote 0.67 raised to the 0, all of those equal 1. To give you an idea of why any positive number raised to the 0 should equal 1, let's look at the motivating example over here to the right. On the one hand, if I took 10 squared and I divided by 10 squared, you would say the answer is 1. On the other hand, if I took 10 squared divided by 10 squared and I used my exponent properties from the previous page, I know I would subtract the exponents, and if I do subtract the exponents, I get 10 to the 0. So on the one hand, 10 squared divided by 10 squared is 1. On the other hand, it's 10 to the 0. Therefore, 10 to the 0 and 1 must be the same thing. We could make this same argument not just with tens, but I could have used a 2, a 3, a 5, regardless. So this result is true for any positive number. Let's look at the next property. The next property says that if you have a number raised to a negative power, this is defined to be 1 over the same number raised to a positive power. For example, if I took 2 and I raised it to the negative 3, we define that to be 1 over 2 cubed. Let's do another example. If I wrote 5 to the negative 2, this is defined to be 1 over 5 squared. This property is not necessarily intuitive at all. So let's look at an example that can help you understand why the property might be true. Let's look at this problem right here. Suppose we took 10 squared and divided it by 10 to the 5th. Now, on the one hand, 10 squared is 10 times 10. 10 to the 5th, of course, is 5 factors of 10. Using the mathematics from the previous screencast, we know we can cancel powers of 10. That would leave us with 3 factors of 10 in the denominator and an answer of 1 over 10 cubed. On the other hand, if I took 10 squared and divided by 10 to the 5th and I used my exponent property from the previous page, we're left with 10 to the 2 minus 5, or 10 to the negative 3. So on the one hand, the answer is 1 over 10 cubed, and on the other hand, the answer is 10 to the negative 3. Since these answers have to be equivalent, therefore 10 to the negative 3 has to be equal to 1 over 10 cubed. This is consistent with this property that we've given here. Example 1.4. Simplify the following expressions. Express your answer as a decimal and not as a power of 10, like we did it on the last page. Let's do this one together. Let's look at part A. 8 times 10 to the 0. 10 to the 0, according to our property above, must equal 1. So really, this is 8 times 1, which is 8. Let's look at B. 9 times 10 to the negative 2. 9, we will just leave that alone. Let's look at 10 to the negative 2. By the property above, 10 to the negative 2 is 1 over 10 squared. 10 squared is equal to 100. This fraction is actually 1/100th. And the result, when I do my multiplication, is 9/100ths. We could write our answer as a fraction like that, or as a decimal, which would be 9/100ths. Let's look at part C. In this problem, you would probably find it helpful, because all of the numbers in this problem are multiplied, we are free to regroup the numbers. And if we regroup the numbers, we can put the 3 and the 2 together, and we can group the powers of 10. If we do this, we can perform the multiplication more simply. 3 times 2, of course, is 6. When we do the multiplication involving the powers of 10, because we're multiplying, we know from the previous page that we add the exponents. Negative 4 plus 9 is 5, and so we get 10 to the fifth. 10 to the fifth is 5 factors of 10. If you work that out on your calculator, you would see that is 100,000 when you multiply 10 by itself 5 times. And when you multiply this out, you get 600,000. Let's look at part D. Again, you may find it helpful to separate out the powers of 10 from the other numerical values in the problem. In this case, I would take this one fraction and break it up into two fractions via multiplication. Now we're free to simplify each fraction separately. 8 divided by 4 is 2. Here, in the next fraction, we're dividing by powers of 10. When we divide by powers of 10, according to our property on the preceding page, we subtract the exponents. Here, we take 3 minus a negative 1 when we do our subtraction. And we will be left with 10 to the fourth power. Is 4 factors of 10. If you use a calculator to multiply that out, you find that you get 10,000. When you multiply the 2, you arrive at 20,000.